إن الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهدي الله فهو المهتد، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ولا مثيل له، ولا ضد ولا ند له. ونشهد أن سيدنا وحبيبنا وشفيعنا وعظيمنا وقائدنا وقرة أعيننا ومولانا محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلوات الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وأزواجه وذرياته وأتباعه وتابعيهم إلى يوم الدين. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله، يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته، ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة، وخلق منها زوجها، وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. أما بعد، My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, today we'll talk about a very significant topic. Indeed, this is a hadith. Imam Bukhari rahimahullah, he narrated this hadith in his Sahih. Not only Imam Bukhari, Imam Muslim, Imam An-Nasa'i, Imam Tirmidhi, Imam Ibn Majah, Imam Malik in his Muwatta, Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal in his Musnad Ahmad, many muhaddiseen, muhaqqiqeen, muallimeen, ulama, they wrote many books even on this significant hadith. They wrote many books on this hadith. Like Imam Ibn Hajar Asqalani rahimahullah, rahmatan wasi'a, he wrote a book on this hadith. The hadith is as follows. Ar-Rasul salawatullahi salamu alayhi says, Abi Hurata radiallahu anhi narrated the hadith that Ar-Rasul salawatullahi salamu alayhi narrated, he says, that sab'atun yadhilluhumullahu fi dhillih yawma la dhilla illa dhilluh. Many of you know this hadith. Seven kind of people, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, they will get the shade of arsh of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of judgment, while there would be no shade except the shade of Allah, meaning the shade of arsh. Day of judgment is not an ordinary day, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam. It's not like 26th of January, you came, subhanAllah, you decorated, you beautified yourself, you had shower, you put perfume on yourself, and then you came to this lovely, great mosque, the Cambridge Central Mosque. The mosque for the Ummah. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Judgment Day is a very scary day, and I don't want to scare you. Indeed, it is a very scary day. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, it's a day of the torment, day of punishment. But the seven kind of people, they wouldn't get the punishment, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam. A day, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah will destroy the earth. And whatever in it, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, A'udhu billahi من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إذا زلزلت الأرض زلزالها وأخرجت الأرض أثقالها وقال الإنسان ما لها يومئذ تحدث أخبارها بأن ربك أوحى لها.
My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, إِذَا زُلْزِلَتِ الْأَرْضُ زِلْزَالَهَا. In زَلْزَلَ, the words زِلْزَل, the two words Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put together. And when, in those in Arabic, when you say the waswasa, الَّذِي يُوَسْوِسُ فِي صُدُورِ النَّاسِ, in a shaitans, his job is to whisper in our sudur, to misguide us, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam. He does it continuously. You are coming to the mosque and he says to go somewhere else. You are in the prayer and the shaitan, one special shaitan, of course he's not special, but a special name, Khinzam. He takes you to somewhere else. You are in the prayer in Cambridge Central Mosque, and he takes you to Whitechapel, for instance. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, he continuously, he whispers. That's why Allah says, الَّذِي يُوَسْوِسُ فِي صُدُورِ النَّاسِ. Likewise, Allah said, إِذَا زُلْزِلَتِ الْأَرْضُ زِلْزَالَهَا. The world, the earth will be shaking continuously, the earthquake. Just a few weeks ago, I went to Morocco. After the earthquake, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, and a place called, this is 57 kilometers away from Marrakesh, Mawla Ibrahim, those who came from Morocco, you know him, or you know this perhaps. And I went on top of the mountains, mountain after mountains, the mountain after mountains, and then on the top of the mountains, there's a city called Mawla Ibrahim. And subhanAllah, I saw the mountains. Because of the earthquake, it's like somebody cuts the cakes into pieces. I don't know what best example I can give you. The way, subhanAllah, after the earthquake, the aftermath I saw there, it's really, really scary, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam. Imagine what would happen on the Day of Judgment. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, you notice the year, in the last year, what happened in Turkey. Within 50 seconds, the whole city was destroyed. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, the earth will take everything, whatever it possesses. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, on this day, on the Day of Judgment, seven kind of people, they will get the shade of Arsh of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number one, Ar-Rasul alayhi salatu salam, he says in his beautiful hadith, Al-Imam al-Adil, the just ruler. Imam doesn't mean that Imam like Sheikh Siraj or Dr. Abdul Hakim Murad comes to the mosque and list the prayer, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam. He is also our imam. They are also our imam. But the imam also means, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, leader, ruler. And adala is very important, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, اِعْدِلُوا هُوَ أَقْرَبُ لِلتَّقْوَى. You need to be just, and this is what? This is the piety, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam. At the time of Ali radiallahu anhu, many of you know this story. At the time of Ali radiallahu anhu, when he was a khalifa, when he was a ruler, when he was Amir al-Mu'mineen, Khalifa al-Muslimin, And he was the right hand of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, son-in-law of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, cousin of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the husband of Fatima radiyallahu anha, Sayyidatu Nisa'i Ahli Jannah, the father of Al-Hassan and Al-Hussein Shababu, subhanallah. Subhanallah, they are the leaders of the Shabab in Paradise. My dear brothers and sisters, and when he was the Khalifa, a Jewish brother, a Jewish man, he borrowed a armor from Ali radiallahu an. After a few days, when Ali radiallahu an, he went to that particular Jewish person's house, and then he refused to give this back. And he says, no, it's mine. What are you talking about, Ali? It's mine. This is my armor. You know this. And Ali radiallahu an, long story short, he went to, he himself, Khalifa, Amirul Mu'min, the leader, who was ruling the country, the world. He went to the judge, the justice, and he to the court in Madinat al-Manawwarah, in Kufa, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam. And then, subhanallah, the judge asked him, do you have any evidence, any receipts? From where did you buy it? Do you have any receipts? Did you go to Tesco's or Sainsbury's or Asda's? From where did you buy it? Or Argos even? My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, then Ali radiallahu anh, he said, I don't have any evidence. Khalas, it's not yours. It belongs to the Jewish man. Because you don't have an adillah. You don't have any evidence. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, then Ali radiallahu anh, subhanAllah, he left the court. The Jewish man came to Ali radiallahu anhu warda, and he said, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, Ya Khalifat al-Muslimin, this armor belongs to you. I lied to you. But subhanAllah, you proved me the justice. SubhanAllah, you did, but I should give it back to you. And also I'm saying that Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, wahdahu la sharika la, wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu rasulah. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, how they practice, the Jewish brother became Muslim, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam. How did they practice adala? A great American scholar, he says that injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere. Today there is lack of justice, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, around the world. SubhanAllah. And for few hundred people, or even less than 200 people, you see thousands of thousands are being killed. You know, subhanAllah, hundreds of hundreds houses and hospitals are being destroyed. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ease the situation of Ummah. We say Ameen, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, وَشَابٌ نَشَأَ فِي عِبَادَةِ اللَّهِ وَشَابٌ نَشَأَ فِي عِبَادَةِ اللَّهِ. The young man, I'm talking about many youngsters here. Even I consider myself young. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, a young man who spends his time to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Young man, subhanAllah, when you are young and energetic, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, lots of waswasa, as I defined waswasa before, comes to you, comes to us. And we are living in a time of fitna, the trials and tribulations, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam. And there are fitna of social media, for instance, the fitna of, subhanAllah, social media is really, really powerful nowadays. Even, sometimes we give the status on Facebook, I'm sleeping, I'm sneezing, I'm this, I'm doing that. Even we share the subhanAllah, the page where you just see the ducks are crossing the road, zebra crossing, and you are sharing this page, you are sharing that story. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, we see lots of messages on WhatsApp, on Facebook, on Messenger. But how about the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Sometimes even we forget to recite, even including myself, to recite Surah Al-Mulk before I go to bed. Even we forget to recite Surah Ayatul Kursi before we go to bed, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam. But we don't forget to see our messages there. وَشَابُ النَّشَافِ عِبَادَةِ اللَّهِ. The man who spends the time worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, our age is very important. The young brothers and sisters, those who are here and involved with the masjid, inshallah ta'ala, for you there is a good news, and I'm going to come to this inshallah ta'ala. Rasulullah alayhi salatu salam, he says, وَرَجُلٌ قَلْبُهُ مُعَلَّقٌ بِالْمَسَاجِدِ. This is the third category. A man whose heart is attached to the mosque. A man, or even sister, whose heart is attached to the mosque. Even you are not in Cambridge, you are in Karachi, Islamabad, you are in Sylhet, you are in Dhaka, you are in New York, you are in Jakarta, subhanallah, you are in Istanbul, but still you feel that your mosque is there, your Cambridge Central Mosque is there. One day Prophet Muhammad salawatullahi salamu alayhi came from a safar. He was traveling and he was looking for a man in the mosque. Where is the man? A lady. He was looking for a lady. Sisters, you listen to this. Our Rasul alayhi salatu salam came to the mosque, and one day, and he was looking for a lady. And he asked the Sahaba radiallahu anhu, where is the lady gone? And the Sahaba radiallahu anhu, what lady are you looking for? The Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, the lady who cleans the mosque. Who is the cleaner of the mosque. Sahaba, they thought, our Rasul alayhi salatu salam, does he care about the cleaner of the mosque? They said, Ya Rasulullah, she died. Oh, she died. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Where is her dead body? Then Sahaba radiallahu anhum, they said, Ya Rasulullah, we buried her. Then Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was really, really sad, and his face became absolutely gloomy. Ar-Rasul alayhi salatu salam, he says, he asked them, where is her dead body? Where did you bury her? Take me to the grave. Ar-Rasul salawatullahi alayhi salamu alayhi. He went to the grave and he prayed over the grave. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, and a cleaner, she was just a cleaner. How about the imam of the mosque? How about the trustees of the mosque? How about the musallin of the mosque? For the cleaner, Ar-Rasul alayhi salatu salam, he missed the janazah. That's why he went to the grave and he prayed over the grave. وَقَلْبُهُنْ مُعَلَّقٌ بِالْمَسَاجِدِ. His heart is attached to the mosque. You are a sister. Your heart is attached to the mosque. Sometimes you miss the prayer, but still your heart is there. Your brother, sometimes you miss the fajr, but still your heart is there. The moment you come to the mosque, the moment you see the imam, you become happy. Your heart is there, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam. Our Rasul alayhi salatu salam, he says, وَرَجُلَانِ تَحَابَ فِي اللَّهِ اجْتَمَعَ عَلَيْهِ وَتَفَرَّقَ عَلَيْهِ. Two men, two brothers, or even two sisters. They love, this is the fourth category, if I'm not mistaken. They will get the shade of Arsh on the day of judgment. They love each other for the sake of Allah. Two brothers, they love for the sake of Allah. Not I support Man U and you support Man U, that's why I love you. Not because you support Liverpool or Liverpool and I support that particular team, that's why I love you. Not because I love chicken biryani and you love chicken biryani. No. For the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. اجتمع عليه. They get together. And then they depart from each other. Even still they love each other for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My dear brothers and sisters Islam, I need to rush, because the clock is ticking. I wanted to give a big, beautiful example of the love of Sahaba radiallahu anhum, but inshallah another day. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, then Rasulullah alayhi salam continues, وَرَجُلٌ طَلَبَتْهُ إِمْرَأَةٌ ذَاتُ مَنْصِبٍ وَجَمَالٍ فَقَالْ إِنِّي أَخَافُ اللَّهِ. And a man is seduced by a woman. Are you listening? A man is seduced by a woman. And the woman comes to do the mischief with him. And then he says, I fear Allah the most. Imam Qurtubi rahimahullah, he says, this is the character of Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam. Very difficult. But may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us this character. We say, Ameen. Ya Rabbal Alameen. And then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says that, وَرَجُلٌ تَصَدَّقَ أَخْفَى حَتَّى لَا تَعْلَمَ شِمَالُهُ مَا تُنْفِقُ يَمِينُهُ. A man who donates with his right hand and left hand doesn't know what is he giving with his right hand, and vice versa, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam. Donation is very important. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam, he says, As-sadaqatu taruddul bala, sadaqa removes bala musiba. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi salam, he says, charity, da'u mardakum bisadaqa. Charity itself is the medicine of the disease, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam. And when we give to the mosque or to any kind of charity, to the poor people or needy, whether it is Palestine, Syria, or Ukraine even, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, we should come out from the riya and sum'a, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us goodness. We say Ameen, Ya Rabbal Alameen. And the seventh kind, Rasul alayhi salatu salam, he says, وَرَجُلٌ ذَكَرَ اللَّهَ خَالِيًا فَفَاضَتْ عَيْنَاهُ. And the man who is alone and he fears Allah the most, and out of fear and the love for the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he sheds his tear, or she sheds her tear. هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم. إن الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي. يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على عبدك ورسولك محمد صاحب وجه الأنوار وضبن الأظهر. ورضى اللهم عن خلفاء الأربعة أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي رضي الله عنهم وسائر صحابة النبي كمحمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وعن التابعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وعنا معهم بعفوك وجودك وكرمك وإحسانك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم انصر المسلمين في كل مكان. اللهم انصر المسلمين والمستضعفين من الرجال والنساء والولدان الذين يقولون ربنا أخرجنا من هذه القرية الظالم أهلها واجعل لنا من لدنك وليا واجعل لنا من لدنك نصيرا. اللهم كن لهم معينا ونصيرا. اللهم كن لهم معينا ونصيرا. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. بفضل سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون سلاما على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. والله يعلم ما تصنعون. أقم الصلاة.